Too kind. Thanks very much indeed. Those were a selection of tunes. The first tune was called The Langstern Pony. The second tune was a reel from the recording of a man called James Morrison called The Tap Room. And the third reel was, or the second reel rather, was called Grant's Reel. Or we'll continue with two jigs. The first tune is called Max Fancies, and the second one was composed by a man called Junior Crehan from Milltown Malway in County Clare called The Mist Covered Mountain. Isn't that lovely?
The plague of conscription. The earliest versions of this song date to the late 17th century. It's a song called The Lowlands of Holland.
On the night that I was married and on my marriage bed, there came a bold captain and stood at my bed head, saying, "Arise, arise, young married man, and come along with me to the lowlands of Holland to fight the enemy." I held my love all in my arms, still hoping he might stay. But the captain, he gave another shout, he was forced to march away, saying, "There's many the blithe young married man, tonight must go with me to the lowlands of Holland to fight the enemy." Now Holland is a wondrous place, and in it grows much green. It's the wife of the nation, for my true love to Caribbean, where the sugar cane grows of a plenty, and there's fruit on every tree. Yet the lowlands of Holland, far should my love and thee. What makes you to the men? Is the hair of a lad is all way town can give you hearts content? Oh, there's lads enough in Galway town, but ne'er a one for me. For I never had but one to love, and she is far a sea. No shoe, no stock, I'll put on no comb go through my hair, no firelight, no candlelight shine in my bower bare. And neither will I marry be until the day I die, since the lowlands of Holland parted my love and I.
Another song this time. I learned the song from the singing of a man called Tully Holleran from Athlone in the county of Westmeath. That's a song called the Bonny Irish Maid.
As I roved out one morning fair, so early as I stretched, it being all in the month of June, the birds sang in the shade. The sun shone down right merrily, and the water did gently flow, where primroses and daisies grow down by black water side. I had not gone but half an hour when there by chance I spied two lovers talking as they walked down by black water side. And as he embraced her in his arms, these words to her he said, "When I'm in America, I'll be bonny Irish maid. When you are in America, the Yankee girls you'll find, and you'll have sweethearts of your own, more pleasing to your mind. Do not forget the promises and the vows to me you made. Oh, stay at home, love, you not home from your bonny Irish maid." But they must be very handsome to remind me of me. For there's not a flower in yonder grove or bloom in yonder glade that can remind me, love, of you, my bonny Irish maid. There's many's the foolish youth, she said, that has gone to some distant shore, leaving his own true love behind, perhaps to meet no more. It's in crossing of the Atlantic's foam sometimes their graves are made. So stay at home, love, do not roam from your bonny Irish maid. Let these sweet hearts together a bond he did embrace, like honey drops upon the dew, the tears ran down her face. There's not a day while you're away, but I'll visit in these days, until you do return again to your bonny Irish maid.
Thank you very much, and alas, we've come to the end of the show, and we're going to finish now with a couple of reels, a couple of rows in reels, please God. The first tune is called the Caledonian Reel, and the second one is called the Dune. Thank you very much, and good night. Thank you.
finally tonight on my TV, music, traditional folk music from Ireland.
Those were two reels. The first one was called Mulvihills, after Charlie Mulvihill, and the second reel was called The Dog. We'll carry on with the song now, which comes from the Coolé Gaeltacht area of West Cork. It's called The Banks of Ceylon.
On a bright summer's morning, as I strayed by the banks of Ceylon, for to gaze on the beauties of nature that grace every woodland and lawn. The prospect was surely entrancing, as gay lassies in juvenile bloom promenade by the banks of that river that flows near the town of Macroom. I've been airy and fond of recreation. By that riverside I chance far to roam. Little weary of my ramblings and roamings, I sat myself down by a brook. I sat there a while meditating, till the sun her bright dress had withdrawn, and the damsel of queenly appearance came down by the banks of Salam. I arose with great joy and emotion, and passed through this vision so fair. She appeared unto me like a adorned with jewels most rare. Were I ruler of France or of Prussia, sure 'tis with me you'll soon wear the crown. And I join you in wedlock, oh my darling, you're the beauty of Massey Town. At length in a voice unaffected, she said, "Sir, my father lives there. His presence to me was appalling. With his cross, angry looks, and his frown that pierced through my heart like an arrow on my way down to Massey Town. Ah, but now I'm retired from my story, with a heart full of sorrow and grief. There is no one in this world to console me, or give me the slightest relief. I will roam through the African desert until death summons me to my tomb, for the sake of that charming fair Helen that I met near the town of Macroom."
Thank you. Thanks very much indeed. We'll continue now, first of all, with two jigs. The first tune comes from a 78 recording, once again, of a man called P.J. Conlon, or Peter Conlon, who was a melodeon player. And that's followed by a tune called Páirc O'Keeffe's. Well, Páirc O'Keeffe is the man that sort of wrote it down in his manuscripts and so on. That's followed by a reel called The Leg of Mutton Number 1. And that's followed by a reel called The Boys of Mallon. So, here we go.
Ha
very much. Thank you very much indeed. We'll continue now with a piece of carillon music. There's lots of carillon tunes popping up all over the place lately, but this is another one anyway, and it's called Mr. O'Connor. More reels. Now, the first tune we think Eddie Kelly from Castlereagh in County Roscommon wrote, as far as we know. Do you know him? Do, maybe. Maybe you don't. But anyway, we'll play Eddie Kelly's and Reeves, two reels. Thank you. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
A song which originates in Scotland, I think, according to the words of it anyway, I think it originates in Scotland. It's an unlikely sort of a tale. It's called The Wedding at Lochie McGrath's. Oh, it's all of a song that I'm now going to prattle. One night I fell in with a gang and the tatter, as sure as your life. Was just like a battle that night at the wedding at Lochie McGrath's. Oh, Ruby Gob, it was a terrible tear. Me and McGrath, me mother was there. And if I get mixed up in the wheels of a train, I may never go to a wedding again. And the first thing that came was a big lot of peelings and a mighty big stew that was made in the heelings. The look of that stew, it hurted our feelings that night at the wedding at Lochie McGrath's. There was plenty to eat, there was fresh bitten liver, as sure as you're there and as sure as you're never. The look of that meat, sure it gave us the fever that night at the wedding at Lochie McGrath's. Oh, a big up, 'twas a terrible tear. Me and McGrath, me mother was there. And if I get mixed up in the wheels of a train, I may never go to a wedding again. There were tinkers and tailors and journeyman-aiders, a zuna, and a bundle of Quakers. The looks on their faces near gave us the shakers that night at the wedding at Lochie McGrath's. And the first to come in was old Mrs. MacRussell. She couldn't well sing and she started to whistle till somebody gave her a rap in the bustle that night at the wedding at Lochie McGrath's. Oh, a big out was a terrible tear. Me and McGrath, me mother was there. And if I get mixed up in the wheels of a train, I may never go to a wedding again. And the next to come in was old Paddy O'Hara. He started to give us a verse of Tarara. I seen all his bones going out in a barrow that night at the wedding at Lochie McGrath's. And the last to come in was old Paddy McGinty. He stood in the door and he started to shinty. He up with the poker, I'm sure he killed 20 that night at the wedding at Lochie McGrath's. Oh, a big up, 'twas a terrible tear. Me and McGrath, me mother was there. And if I get mixed up in the wings of a plane, I may never go to a wedding again.
We're going to finish now, but first of all, I'd like to thank you all for coming along tonight. Our producer, Noel Green, and all the RTE crowd, and of course, ourselves, the Dannan. We're going to finish with... Oh, God bless you. What in the name of God made me say that? Anyway, we have Brendan Bronick to thank for these next two tunes. The first one, there was no title on it, so we titled it ourselves, and it's called The Trip to Tume, and the second one is called The Lobster.
Thank you.
very much.
We're going to play a fling and a hornpipe, and the fling has a few words. It's called Love, Will You Marry Me? It's a woman proposing to a man and receiving very evasive answers. Well, they become brutally frank at the end. In fact, Brutally Frank was the name of the man in question.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The hornpipe is called O'Burns, I believe.
Never could to gain you.